Okay, this is John Rappaport's blog, nomorefakenews.com, and The Real News. In previous articles, he's established the fact that the existence of the SARS-CoV-2 is unproven and has brought forth Dr. Tom Cowan's evidence in the genetic sequence of the virus was cobbled together piecemeal from databases based on zero science. In other words, the sequencing was a fraud. The chosen direction of the fraud, a coronavirus, that was the arbitrary choice. Researchers picked off the data shelf a new coronavirus, meaning they assembled pieces of genetic code they claimed were corona, and they hooked them up and said, voila, we have a new SARS-type virus. If you look at the motley collection of pre-pandemic drills and exercises and conferences, the theoretical virus almost always turned out to be a coronavirus. That was the preordained storyline. That was the plan, selling that story. Is John suggesting that many, many scientists and even political leaders and globalist big shots knew in advance that no real virus would ever be discovered, that the sequencing would be fake? Of course not. In every major covert operation, information is compartmentalized. In this particular operation, we have a stunning fact. Almost everyone automatically believes the genetic sequencing and the virus are real. That goes for elite scientists as well. They're in the dark. Only a very few are aware of the whole process of cobbling together the, quote, new virus, end quote, is fraught with fraud. So for all intents and purposes, the virus con is protected. It's protected by institutionalized science, by massive consensus and massive ignorance. The situation is even more stunning than that. All over the world, there are scientists in labs of various kinds who believe they're working with the virus when they're working with a cobbled-together idea of the virus. So for the most part, in this COVID operation, the key players are only aware that researchers could arbitrarily choose one virus over another as the cause of the pandemic. They're not aware that the choice is actually a fake virus. The choice of a new coronavirus was made for a simple reason. The diagnostic test would turn up huge numbers of false positives, thus jacking up case numbers and providing the rationale for the lockdowns and the economic devastation, which were all along the real aims of the operation. To put it more specifically, the PCR test would register positive because it was geared to detect genetic sequences commonly present in all people all over the world. To put it another way, the PCR test was preset with data, which would match the data extracted from patients. The fix was in. The virus was concocted out of data. It was and is data. The test was loaded with data that frequently matches the virus data. Think of it this way. You have a map of a lost gold mine. It seems to chart a course through the mountains and valleys of California. Of course, the map is fake. It was drawn and made to look old. You follow the map, and sure enough, in a remote mountain area, you arrive at a giant hole in the side of a hill. But the hole and the mine are fake, too. They're a Potemkin village. The tunnel and the braces and the struts were built recently. The map matches the mine. Fake leads to fake. In the digital age, any material thing can be digitized. The material thing is then represented by code. Activate the code, and a virtual portrait of the thing pops up. But it's just as easy to invent code for something that doesn't exist or has never been proven to exist, like SARS-CoV-2. Pure gold and pure garbage are made interchangeable in the form of data. Thanks, kids. Thank you, John Rappaport.